Yes guys, question number 11. The following is a summarized balance sheet of big and small for the year ending 31st March 2012. There is some balance sheet which is given to you, big and small. The present worth of fixed assets are 200 and that of small is 429. Goodwill is 40 and 75 crores. Small absorbs big. Okay, so it's the reverse one. Don't think that big is absorbing small. Small absorbs big limited by issuing equity shares at par in such a way that the intrinsic net worth is maintained. Goodwill account is not to be opened in the books of accounts and fixed assets are to be appeared at old figures. Show the balance sheet after absorption and draft the statement for valuation of shares on intrinsic value basis to prove the accuracy of your workings. So, is asking you to maintain the intrinsic value. So, let's start. Put a heading, intrinsic value per share. Purchase consideration. Intrinsic value. Big and small. So, to get intrinsic value, we need to first calculate net assets. So, let's start with net assets. Assets. What are your assets existing there? First one is fixed assets. My fixed assets appearing there. He is saying that the revalued figures of fixed assets are 200 and 429. Then we have our current assets. There is no revaluation given for the current assets. Current assets minus current liabilities. Net figure is given to us as 200 and 200. Net current assets. And then I have goodwill, third asset. Goodwill is 40 and 75. Total assets. Outside liabilities. Only one outside liability existing there, that is secured loans. Hundred. Get the value of net assets. Total is 440. Net asset is 340. This total is 704 and this is 604. Deduct preference share capital 60 and this will give you net assets attributable to equity shareholders. Answers are 340 and 544. Divided by number of equity shares, 5 and 4. Intrinsic value per share, 68, 136. Easy to get exchange ratio. That's a perfect divisible figures. So So yes guys, so how do we get exchange ratio? Exchange ratio, be careful, because you need to know the selling company. Intrinsic value of selling by intrinsic value of purchasing. Here, what is selling? Small absorbs big. So big is selling, small is purchasing. 68 by 136, or simply I can say 1:2. Number of equity shares to be issued by small. How many will they issue? How many shares are there in big? 5. Exchange ratio 1:2, or 1 by 2. Number of shares to be issued is 2.5. Read the question carefully. In the second para after the table, small limited absorbs big limited by issuing equity shares at par. At par. So the issue price, you can't take it as whatever figure you want. I'll take the issue price as only rupees 10. PC will be 25. Normally we will take issue price as intrinsic value of selling purchasing company. We have to take it as 136, but here I is clearly saying issued at par, so I'll take it as 10. PC is 25. Now check for the nature of amalgamation and method of accounting, which is very very important for us. Check what is the nature of amalgamation. Very good. It is merger. Reason is, yes, it is not purchase, it is merger. Read. Goodwill limited, goodwill will not be appearing in the books. Fixed assets are to be appearing at old book values itself. So there itself you need to understand he is maintaining the same book value of the assets. All assets are taken over. No revaluation in the assets. Purchase consideration in the form of equity shares. Absolutely a merger. Nature of amalgamation. Merger, method of accounting, pooling of interest. What do you do when you have pooling of interest method? Reserves of selling companies taken over. Come on. Maintain the working note now. What is the selling company? Reserves of big taken over. Big limited taken over. How do you go about with the working note? First, identify surplus. How do we identify surplus? Compare your purchase consideration $25, deduct less share capital of selling company, share capital of big. $50. There is no surplus. You have negative $50 or negative $25. Whenever you have negative surplus, what do we do? Negative surplus always transfer to capital reserve. Straightforward, I can say reserves taken over. I'm not writing reserve adjust, surplus adjust against reserve, anything, because there is no surplus only. What is the point of writing all that? Come on, what is a reserve? Reserve and surplus existing in the balance sheet of biggest 200. Straightforward, happily take over reserves and surplus 200. Absorb the 200 rupees. Strike the balance sheet after that. Balance sheet of small. As on 31st March 2012, equity and liabilities. Shareholder funds, share capital, equity share capital and 10% preference share capital. Equity share capital already existing was 40 plus now additional capital is 25 plus 65. Preference share capital no change 60. Reserves and surplus. Our capital reserve first. That negative surplus transfer to capital reserve was 25. And I have other reserves. I already had 150. I am taking over even big limited's 200. So this will become 350. Non-current liabilities, only one item, secured loans, 100 plus 100, I'll take over that, 200, that's it for the balance sheet liability side. Come to the assets. Non-current assets. There is no revaluations to be considered. Should be appearing at book values. That is what he has given. So I'll talk about fixed assets now. Tangible fixed assets. And a non-current assets. Book values add. That is 150 plus 150, 300. There's no non-current assets, no intangible assets. And directly I have current assets. $200 plus $200, $400. Balance sheet total is $700. Yes guys, turn to the 12th question. Read, A Limited agreed to take over B Limited on 1st October and no balance sheet was prepared on that date. The balance sheet which is available to us is on 31st March 2011. So that means 6 months before the takeover date. And he's saying for 6 months period from 1st April, A Limited made a profit of 4,20,000 after writing off a depreciation at the rate of 10% per annum on its fixed assets. So 6 months, I'll take only 5% depreciation. For the same period, that is from 1st April to 1st October, B Limited made 2,04,000 profit after writing off a depreciation of 10% per annum again, so 5% on fixed assets. Only 6 months depreciation should be considered. Both the companies in 1st August paid an equity dividend of 15% and income tax on such dividends were 10%. Goodwill of B Limited was valued at 1,20,000 on the date of takeover. And the stock of B Limited was subjected to an abnormal item of 7,500 to be fully written off, was to be appreciated by 25% for the purpose of takeover. Please clearly understand the words for the purpose of takeover on the date of takeover. That is only for the purpose of takeovers. A Limited to issue B Limited shareholders fully paid equity shares of 10 rupees each on the basis of comparative intrinsic value on the date of takeover and draft the balance sheet of A Limited after the absorption of B. All working notes forming part of your answer. If you observe point number 1, 2, 3, no place is talking about on the date of takeover, for the purpose of takeover. These things are not there. The reason is, those first 3 points are necessary for you to draft a balance sheet on the date of takeover. What was the date of takeover? 1st October. Balance sheet given to us is only on 31st March. So I need to draft a balance sheet on 1st October for both the companies for the purpose of takeover. And then we have to start solving the problem. So the first 3 points which are given to you is only for the purpose of understanding what is a balance sheet on 1st October. But the 4th point, goodwill of B Limited valued at 1,20,000 on the date of takeover, stock of B Limited subjected to an abnormal item of 7,500 to be fully written off, would be appreciated by 25% for the purpose of takeover. For the purpose of takeover, that means the 4th point should not be considered in drafting your balance sheet on 1st October. It should be only considered for the purpose of calculating your purchase consideration. So until then, I will not consider the 4th point. So consider only the first 3 points and draft the balance sheet. When you are drafting the balance sheet, I don't need Schedule 6. Because it's only a working note, you can prepare it in a normal T-shaped format, whatever is given in the question. Got it? So let's start. Start preparing the balance sheet on 1st October 2011. Such problems tend to be lengthier guys because you are not given the balance sheet also on the date of takeover. You have to give the balance sheet on the date of takeover and then you have to go on with your normal amalgamation process. Normal absorption process will continue after that. Balance sheet as on 1st October 2011. Gone. First one, there will not be any change as far as your share capital is concerned. Share capital will stay as 15 lakhs and 10 lakhs. Next, reserves and surplus. First item is a reserve. My reserve 4,15,000 and 2,56,000, this will not change. What will change is your P&L. Because there is some 6 months profit which is given, there is some dividend which are declared out of it. So P&L will change, we'll park it aside, we'll fill up the figures later. Come to the other items. I have creditors also in the balance sheet. He never said there is a change in the value of the creditors. So you can observe the same values as far as the creditors is concerned. 93,750 and 75,000. Come to the asset side, fixed assets. Fixed assets, they are depreciated at the rate of 10% per annum. Or I can say it is 5% on a half yearly basis. So come on, check the depreciation. 12,50,000, 5% depreciation, so minus 5% is 11,87,500. 8,75,000, again 5% depreciation. Stock, there is no change to the stock. Stock is only changed for the purpose of takeover, not for the purpose of drafting your balance sheet of six months. So 2,37,500 and 1,87,500. No change even for your debtors. There's nothing which is suggested there. So I'll take this as 3,90,000 and 2,56,000 only. Bank will change because you're earning profit, you're paying dividend. This will change compulsory. We'll park it aside, leave it later. Finally, preliminary expenses. Preliminary expenses are 25,000 and 12,500. How many items are blanks? Two. P&L as well as balance sheet. I know one thing. If I calculate either of them, the other one will be the balancing figure. Because the balance sheet always tallies. So if I fill up P&L or if I fill up bank, the other one I can call it as balancing figure. Easiest always to calculate is your P&L. Because to calculate cash in bank, we need to go for cash flow statement, which becomes quite lengthy. Let's try to put it short. Let's try to make P&L. P&L as on 1st October 2011. Maintain two columns, A and B, and start solving. Start with the balances given. Balance as on 1st April. What is the balance on 1st April in the balance sheet? The closing balances can be considered. 1,87,500. And 1,50,000. These are the balances given to us. Give the adjustment. Add profit for 6 months. My 6 months profit is 4,20,000 for A, 2,04,000 for B. Deduct the dividends. Dividend paid. What is the dividend paid? How much is he paying dividends? Point number 3. Equity dividends are paid at the rate of 15%. There is no per annums for dividends, guys. 15% on the paid up share capital. 15% of 15 lakhs is 2,25,000 and 1,50,000. Read the continuing point. Tax on such payments was 10% also to be paid. So this is tax on dividends. Less tax on dividend. 10% of the dividend paid. 22,500 and 15,000. This will give you P&L balance as on 1st October. Once you get the P&L balances, post it into the balance sheet and find out the bank as balancing figure. Your bank should be balancing figure after you place your P&L balances into the balance sheet. Much? 360,000. 189,000. Just place these values into the balance sheet. 360 and 189. And you can calculate the bank as a balancing figure. Place the balancing figures in the bank. $528,750 and $232,750 are your bank balances as on 1st October. Now, based on this balance sheet, I have to take over. Based on this balance sheet, I'll start calculating PCE because the date of takeover is 1st October. So let's check PCE. How do you get PCE? Information given to us. Read that. Point number 4. Goodwill of B Limited is valued at 1,20,000 on the date of takeover, and the stock of B subjected to an abnormal item of 7,500 is to be fully written off, would be appreciated by 25% for the purpose of takeover. Now, and he is also saying that A will issue B shareholders fully paid shares of 10 rupees each on the basis of the comparative intrinsic value of shares on the date of takeover. So, intrinsic value is based on the balance sheet. Now, let's take up. Purchase consideration. A and B, maintain two columns and start. Intrinsic values. Start with your assets. The first asset not appearing in the balance sheet but given to us separately is the value of goodwill. There is an adjustment to stock which I will also take up. But first take up goodwill adjustment. Goodwill of B Limited is valued at 1,20,000 for the purpose of takeover. A, no goodwill. B, 1,20,000 goodwill. Come on, now take up one by one from the balance sheet. Fixed assets, 11,87,500, 8,31,250. Debtors, book values being 3,90,000, 2,56,000. Stock, there's a change. A, no change. Direct 237,500 only. But B, 187,500, read the adjustment. Stock of B subjected to an abnormal item of 7,500 to be fully written off. So 1,80,000 minus 7,500 is 1,80,000 would be appreciated by 25% for the purpose of takeover. That means it should be increased by 45,000. 25%, that is 2,25,000. You have bank balance, you can directly take over the bank balances as it is. 5,28,750, 2,32,750. Go for outside liabilities. I have only one outside liability. If you observe there, there's only creditors. There is 93,750 and 75,000. Strike there, we get net assets. These are net assets attributable to equity shareholders directly because there is no preference share capital. To get intrinsic value, what do? Divide it by number of equity shares. Number of equity shares. Each share being 10 rupees. Number of equity shares are 1,50,000 and 1,00,000. Divided, automatically we get intrinsic value per share. Place the figures, come on. Fill up the intrinsic values from there. Yes guys, check your totals. So this is 15.9. Get the exchange ratio. Exchange ratio is intrinsic value of selling B by intrinsic value of purchasing A. 15.9 by 15, leave it. No problem. Or even if you want to solve, it is basically 1.06. Once you know the exchange ratio, you can also calculate number of shares to be issued. Number of shares to be issued by A. How many shares are there in B? B Limited has 1 lakh shares. You are issuing at 1.06 exchange ratio. So, the total number of shares to be issued are 1,06,000. Issue price per share at the intrinsic value of purchasing company, that is A. Issue price per share is intrinsic value of A, 15 rupees. That will give us PC of again 15,90,000. Cross verification, check with your net assets. Net asset total is again 15,90,000. Next one should be nature of amalgamation and method of accounting. Check for the nature of amalgamation. Nature of amalgamation. Purchase. Reason is stock and goodwill. Method of accounting is purchase method. So if it is a purchase method, what do we have to calculate? Very good. You don't have to calculate only. We have already seen one thing. Whenever your purchase consideration is calculated as per your net assets method, and if it is your amalgamation by nature of purchase, then the goodwill will be the same goodwill which you have included in your net assets calculation. So directly I can say my goodwill is 1,20,000. I don't have to go and check what is net assets, what is the purchase consideration. I don't have to go for all that. We have already reduced one thing, saying that if your PC is calculated as per net assets method and your amalgamation is by nature of purchase, then the same goodwill what is included in the computation of net assets will appear in the balance sheet. Directly balance sheet of A. Balance sheet of A as on 1st October 2011. This is post-merger balance sheet which is required for you to prepare. Equity and liabilities. Shareholder funds. Share capital. Only equity exists. Already existing equity share capital in A is 15 lakhs. Now I am issuing 1,06,000 shares. 1,06,000 shares, each one of 10 rupees each. So it will be 10,60,000. Add 10,60,000 to 15 lakhs. The total share capital is 25,60,000. Reserves and surplus. First one is securities premium. What is securities premium? Per share 5 rupees. On for 1,06,000 shares, if you take 5 rupees, it should be 5,30,000. Relax. There is preliminary expenses which can be written off. Preliminary expense of 25,000, strike it off from your securities premium. Your balance of securities premium should be 1,05,000 to 5,30,000 minus 25,000, 5,05,000. What about this preliminary expense of B? I won't take over the preliminary expenses because it is a fictitious asset. Continue. There's one more reserve which we have to take over, that is P&L. Oh no, first one reserve is there. Amalgamation by nature of purchase, selling company reserves not to be considered. Only purchasing company reserves, 4,15,000. P&L, 3,60,000. There is no non-current liabilities at all. But there is current liability. Current liabilities are creditors. You need to combine both. You get 1,68,750. Balance sheet total on the liability side. Assets. Non-current assets. Tangible fixed assets. add up. Tangible fixed assets total should be 20 lakh 18,750. Intangible asset goodwill. ₹1,20,000 for the purpose of takeover. Final current assets. Don't check your balance sheet. Check your net assets computation. Debtors. Stock. Bank. Debtor 3,90,000 plus 2,56,000 is 6,46,000. Stock 2,37,500 plus 2,25,000. 4,62,500. Bank 5,28,750 plus 2,32,750. It is 7,61,500. And the balance sheet should tally there. Check. Balance sheet total is 40,08,750. When you are adding up your values in your balance sheet, always check your PC net assets calculation. You are just line by line adding these values. So fixed assets, everything will be line by line additions. Don't check the balance sheet because there is change in the values of stock.